हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ईसे एकेडमी।
इन दिस लेक्चर लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड ए प्रॉब्लम ऑन ट्रांसफॉर्म एनालिसिस ऑफ LTI सिस्टम। हियर ए कॉजल सिस्टम इज गिवन विथ इनपुट x ऑफ n एंड आउटपुट y ऑफ n। वी नीड टू फाइंड द इम्पल्स रेस्पॉन्स ऑफ दिस सिस्टम इफ x ऑफ n एंड y ऑफ n इज गिवन। Let us consider x of n that can be given as delta of n plus 1 by 4 delta of n minus 1 minus 1 by 8 delta of n minus 2. For this, let us take z transform. Therefore, we can write x of z is equal to delta of n, we can write it as 1 plus 1 by 4. Delta of n minus 1, we can write that as z to the power of minus 1 minus 1 by 8. Delta of n minus 2, we can write it as z to the power of minus 2. Now let us consider y of n, that is given as delta of n minus 3 by 4 delta of n minus 1. Again, let us take z transform of the above equation. Therefore, we can write y of z is equal to delta of n, we can write it as 1 minus 3 by 4 delta of n minus 1, we can write it as z to the power of minus 1. We know transfer function can be written as the transfer function, or system function can be written as h of z, that can be given as y of z divided by x of z. So from above equation we can write h of z is equal to 1 minus 3 by 4 z inverse divided by 1 plus 1 by 4 z inverse minus 1 by 8 z to the power of minus 2. Now for this equation let us multiply and divide by z square. Let us multiply and divide with z square. Therefore, we'll get h of z is equal to z square minus 3 by 4 z divided by z square plus 1 by 4 z minus 1 by 8. From the numerator, if we take z as common, so we can write that as z into z minus 3 by 4 divided by z square plus 1 by 4 z minus 1 by 8. Therefore, we can write h of z divided by z is equal to z minus 3 by 4 divided by z square plus 1 by 4 z minus 1 by 8. Now, if we find the roots of the denominator, at that case, we can write the equation as z minus 3 by 4 divided by, so we'll get the roots as z plus 1 by 4 into z minus 1 by 4. So we can write this equation as a divided by z plus 1 by 4 plus b divided by z minus 1 by 4 using partial fraction. Let us call this as equation number 1. Now, we can write equation number 1 as z minus 3 by 4 is equal to a into z minus 1 by 4 plus b into z minus 1 by 2. Let us take this as equation number 2. In equation number 2, if we put z is equal to 1 by 4, at that case, we will get minus 5 by 4 is equal to b into minus 3 by 4, a term will become 0. So from this we can find b is equal to 5 by 3. In equation number 2, if we put z is equal to minus 1 by 2, at that case we'll get minus 1 by 2 is equal to a into 3 by 4. From this we can write a is equal to minus 2 by 3. So we got the value of a and b. Let us substitute this value in equation number 1. Therefore, we can write equation number 1 as h of z divided by z is equal to minus 2 by 3 divided by z plus 1 by 2 plus 5 by 3 divided by z minus 1 by 4. Above equation, we can write it as h of z is equal to, if we multiply this z term towards RHS, we will get minus 2 by 3 into z divided by z plus 1 by 2 plus 5 by 3 into z divided by z minus 1 by 4. Now, if we take inverse z transform and if you use the standard formula, which is z divided by z minus a, we can write this as a to the power of n u of n. Therefore, if we take inverse z transform of this h of z, we can write it as h of n, that can be written as minus 2 by 3 into minus 1 by 2 whole to the power of n u of n plus 5 by 3 into 1 by 4 whole to the power of n u of n. So this is h of n for given problem. So we can write one more step for this. So here we can take h of n is equal to, if we take 1 by 3 as common, at that case we can write 5 into 1 by 4 whole to the power of n u of n minus 2 into minus 1 by 2 whole to the power of n u of n. So this will be your final expression. So this is the problem on transform analysis of LTI system. Hope you have understood the topic. Thank you.